If you're into presentations or teaching something through screen sharing with others, you know you cannot annotate, highlight, or zoom into the screen while presenting. This is possible in some presentation softwares like Microsoft PowerPoint, for example, to some extent, but not without showing the audience what you're actually doing in front of them. So something like this one. But here's what's possible after you watch this video. You could draw, write, highlight directly over most desktop applications, including the presentation software and web pages. Here's how to get that done.
Just head on to this website, which is from Microsoft. It's the SysInternals download section. I'll provide the link to this website in the description below. Once you're here, click on the download ZoomIt link, which will download a zip file. So once the zip file gets downloaded, click on it to open it. This only contains the exe file, and this is a portable file. As you can see, you only have to double click to operate it. This opens up an options dialog box where we can find a lot of options. The first thing that you see here is for the zooming. So with this keyboard shortcut zoom, the control 1, by hitting this we can zoom in on the screen, not only in PowerPoint presentations as I mentioned before, but anywhere on your computer screen. So let's try that out right away. I'm just going to hit control 1 on my keyboard, and as you can see, this zooms in and follows my cursor wherever I go. And to go back to the normal mode, I only have to either hit the escape button or just right click on the screen, and that zooms out from the screen. So I'm going to do this, and then I'll hit control 1 keyboard shortcut again to zoom out. So that's pretty neat. The next thing is, let me open up the options again. So the next thing is live zoom, which is the difference between zoom and live zoom is that zoom zooms out whenever we right click or do any other actions on the screen or hit the escape button. But live zoom, which is activated with control plus 4, let's see now how it performs instead of just me telling it. I'm going to hit control 4 on the screen, so this zooms in, and I can also work on the screen, but with, I'm going to zoom out now, but I'm not, I'll hit control 1 again. With this I cannot operate or click anywhere on the screen, so that brings up some other option. So zoom out again, and then I'm going to hit control 4. This lets me operate on the screen while zooming in, so I can just type or do any other actions like keyboard selections or show something. So this is a live zoom. It lets me operate on the screen while zoomed in. That's the difference between zoom and live zoom. Now I'm going to open the options again and go to the third tab, which talks about drawing, where with this keyboard shortcut, the default one, control plus 2, let's see what happens. I'm going to hit control 2 on the screen, so that brings up the annotation options. So for now I can just do a freehand drawing by clicking on my left mouse button. When I right click, this goes away. So hit again control 2, I can draw, and while hitting the tab key when I draw, I get an ellipse, oval shape or circle that I can draw to highlight any section of the page. And with the shift key, I get a straight line. With the shift and control pressed together, I get an arrow, a pointer. And with just the control alone, I can get a square or a rectangle. One thing to mention here is that with this annotation option activated from ZoomIt, if you are connected to another monitor, like a dual or three monitors at a time, then you may not be able to switch to other screens. For example, now I'm connected to a dual monitor, but if you see on the right side here, I'm not able to move beyond my primary screen. So that's one demerit with this annotation option. But as long as you are on presentation mode for just one screen, then this shouldn't be a problem, because it makes sense that you're on one screen and you only want to annotate on that particular screen. So moving on, I'm going to show now the other options, which is So we saw the drawing option, and next is the typing. So let's see how to type in. The same keyboard shortcut suits works here, which is Control 2. And once we are on Control 2, I just have to hit on the keyboard key T. So by hitting T, I can just type something here on the screen wherever we want. And by clicking the Control and then scrolling up and down, we can increase the font size like this. And escape again, so this goes away. Now there are some options wherein we can change the color of the annotations. So hitting Control 2 again brings up this option. If you want to change the color from pink to any other, there are six colors available from this Zoomit software here. So let's see what are those. Hitting on R keyboard shortcut, I get the red. Then G gives me green. Hitting on B gives us blue. Then Y gives yellow. O for orange. And lastly, P for pink. So these are the six colors that are available from this tool. That's pretty much it about the software. And on this last tab, we can see that there is a break option, which means that you can, while giving a presentation, you could, this is the Control 3 keyboard shortcut. So let's demo that right away instead of. So what this does is, I'm going to hit the Control 3, which brings up a timer on the screen live. So in case you're planning to give breaks during your presentations, you could have a timed break. And that's all about it. Hitting the escape key takes it away. That's all about this Zoomit. So in case you are in teaching profession or in a training department from your in your company, then this is something, a very useful tool to keep handy. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked this video. Please also visit my website techlibrary.tv to learn more interesting tips and tricks. I'll see you again in my next video. Bye.